In Japan, an earthquake can happen at any time. What do you do when one occurs? So I called the Tokyo Fire Department to ask them the specific measures that we should take when one happens. And they told me that they have a disaster learning center here in Sumida Ward between Kinchicho Station and the Tokyo Skytree. They also have an earthquake simulator that can simulate the Great Tohoku Earthquake of 2011. Keep watching until the end of this video because I'm going to share with you my personal experience when the Great Tohoku Earthquake occurred, something that changed my life and the way I see this country. Let's go to the Tokyo Fire Department's Disaster Learning Center.
Only in Japan.
The Tokyo Fire Department knows the value in educating people. It makes their job easier and it saves lives. The Honjo Bosaikan, or Life Safety Learning Center for Disasters, is free to visit and gives great insight into how to survive the worst disasters. It's very family-friendly, with many things in English to help new foreign residents learn too. There are videos of catastrophic events and interactive quizzes. You won't leave here without learning something useful. This liquefaction simulator shows just how dangerous earthquakes can be under the ground. By definition, it occurs when waterlogged sediments at or near the ground surface lose their strength in response to the strong ground shaking. The ground becomes liquid and swallows everything from the surface. Besides earthquakes, Japan also has typhoons, hurricane-like storms originating in the Pacific. They bring heavy winds and rains, and this simulation helps us understand why we should stay inside during a storm by experiencing it.
So we're gonna try to just experience a rainstorm situation, probably in the worst possible way. Hana's gonna be joining us. Let's go inside and see how this works.
Unlike virtual reality simulators, this one you really can feel. We were led inside the room with coats, boots, and masks to a pole to hang on to.
All right. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right.
We knew what was coming, but we didn't know what it would be like. And we didn't have to wait long to find out. I couldn't put my head up or let go of the railing. It's easy to understand how one could lose control and be tossed into an unfortunate situation. This was not like any ride at an amusement park.
Rain. So although we're in a simulation situation, it's kind of fun because we know we're in a safe environment. But to experience the kind of winds that does blow people away really makes you think about, well, you have to be prepared. And when this kind of wind and storm is out there, don't go outside. Stay inside, try to be safe. And you, after experiencing it, you can understand why. And I think that's why this is pretty important.
I asked Imamura-san, director of the Learning Center, why he believes these kinds of disaster simulations are so important.
あ、そうですね。例えば地震の場合ですね、その地震の揺れを経験したことのない人がいきなり地震体験したときに、どうしても慌ててしまいます。ただ、あらかじめシミュレートで地震を体験することで、地震が来たときに、そのときに慌てないで適切な行動が取れるようになります。自分や、あるいは家族、 仲間を守れるようになってもらうというのが目的です。地震が送ったら何の情報を伝えたいですか？何？そうですね。日本の場合はですね、建物が大体地震に強くしなければいけない決まりになっています。だから、滅多なことでは地震で建物が倒れたりとか崩れたりっていうのは今はあまりないと思っています。なので、その場で近くでまず自分の身、特に頭を優先して守ってもらって、
This is the earthquake simulation room. It has been engineered to give visitors a serious shake, exactly like some of the worst earthquakes in Japanese history. This is as real as it gets. You know, of course, to the real thing, an earthquake.
So now we're gonna be entering the simulation room. This is where it all happens, a chance for you to try some very serious earthquakes. Now, in Japan, as I said before, earthquake is not measured in magnitude, but Shindo.
It's important to understand how Japan measures earthquakes. Magnitude is an estimate of the relative size or strength of an earthquake from 1 to 10, although 9.4 is the highest known event. This scale sums up the size and strength of the numerical figure. The 2011 Great Tohoku Earthquake measured a 9.1 and is the fourth greatest earthquake in recorded history. The Japanese system is different though. The Shindo intensity scale measures the degree of shaking in the event of an earthquake on a scale from 0 to 7. This is different because it doesn't measure the size or intensity, but the actual shaking in the areas impacted by the release of energy. Here's the scale. You don't really feel it until Shindo 3. At Shindo 5, there are variations, a lower and upper. At Shindo 6, you can't stand up. At Shindo 7, you lose all body control, and you may be thrown into the air. Shindo 7 earthquakes have only been measured 4 times in Japan. We're about to simulate 2 of them right now.
Wow. This one is going to be the 1995 Great Hanshin Earthquake that devastated Kobe. Is extremely strong, and they can simulate that here, so we're going to give that a try. Okay, this.
That button reads Shindo 7. The Great Hanshin Earthquake hit Kobe on January 17th, 1995 at 5:46 a.m.
All right.
The city was asleep. Imagine being in your bed as it starts off this violently.
Oh, this one. Ah, this fell down over. Oh, that's still going on. Just because it kind of settles down, the earthquake sometimes is not over. You can feel it. There are aftershocks as well. You can still feel some of the rumbling. The simulation actually has sound effects of the things going on around you, which is incredible. It seems too real.
6,434 people are believed to have lost their lives, the epicenter very close to the city of Kobe, causing catastrophic damage. This triggered over 300 fires, which ravaged many parts of the city.
That one you cannot even prepare for. It just suddenly happens. The earthquake just hits you. There's nothing you could do in that kind of a situation. You have a very short amount of time to react. So that's why this kind of training is important for you to realize that at a moment, these earthquakes can strike, and the way you react can save your life. So you can see we're resetting it. Everything has moved. Swing it. And this table is 重いじゃん. Wow. This is the simulation of the 311 earthquake. Wow, in Tohoku. Okay, I'm ready. I have some bad memories of this. Oh! Oh my God! Everything is moving all around me. You can feel just this rumbling going up and down. The entire trailer here is shaking. It says it lasts about a minute. I'm just gonna go underneath this table here because I just don't know what else to do. Whoa! This is really, really long. That brings back a lot of memories that I never wanted to experience again.
That was quite an experience that I've been through before, and just the length of it. At first, you don't know what to do. You're like a deer in headlights when an earthquake like this hits, and then anything that you've had, any kind of training, will kick in. You get underneath the table or you brace yourself somewhere. My first reactions were not good many years ago when I was in that earthquake here in Tokyo, but to experience it again, it brought back some really tough memories.
その地震感じた本当に思い出した、なんか同じものを見たい、その日。なんでその地震、シミュレーションできますか？今、日本では地震が起こりそうな時とか起こった時に、細かくデータすぐ情報を出したり、予測を正しくするために地震計がいっぱいあります。その地震計のデータ、それをもらって、そのデータを真似て地震の体験の揺れを作っています。
地震はいつでも来る。小さい地震になったら、まあ市民はあまり何もしないね、みんな続けるので、とか外国人はすぐにテーブルに飛ぶでしょ。正しいですね。正しい。日本人地震にちょっと慣れすぎてます。でもさっきやってもらったみたいに、最初揺れが弱いなと思っても、いきなり強い地震がドカンと来たりとかすることあります。なので地震は どのぐらい強いのか来てみないと分かりませんので、とりあえず自分の身を守ることを考えてもらった方がいいと思います。
At a nearby park, I reflected back on that tragic day, March 11th, 2011.
That was actually hard for me to be in that earthquake simulation during the exact thing, the exact pattern of what happened on March 11th, 2011. It was like after that simulator ended, a lot of the memories came back to me of that day. I was at home in front of the computer editing videos, and I was frozen. I was in my seat in front of my desk, and I didn't know what to do. I looked out the window behind me, and my building, I'm on the sixth floor, it was swaying like I was on a boat. I think about 20 seconds into it, I finally got up, and I put my hand on the doorknob and thought about going outside, but then I didn't. I just stayed there in the doorway, and then it just started to go down again. My heart was racing. I was really freaked out. The first thing I did was call my friends, call people that I knew, and ask them if they were okay, ask them what happened. I went onto the television, I picked it up off of the floor and watched NHK, and you could see that they had experienced the same thing in the studio across town. And a lot of people left Japan in 2011, and this channel was started as a reaction to a lot of information not being conveyed correctly, maybe, to the public, to just build a positive image about Japan. That's why I started this channel. So that's why this episode really does mean a lot to me to be able to do, because I was experienced it myself.
No matter the amount of training you do, an actual Shindo 7 earthquake is going to frighten you. You will feel helpless. The entire world around you will be unstable. The impact goes beyond just the shaking. Living in Japan means you must learn your area's disaster plan and be as ready as you can be if the big one does occur. I hope you learned something. Leave me your thoughts in the comments below, your experience, your stories. After the earthquake, I volunteered as much as I could, food runs, digging mud out of houses, just listening to others and being a friend. It's a reason why I'm still here in Japan and why it's important for me to keep making this series, only in Japan. Here in Japan, life can change in an instant. Stay safe, everyone, and remember to care about the people around you. Mata ne.